What's going on, everybody? This is Q here with another episode of Viewpoint Asia. So today, everyone, I have another special guest today for you. But in order to get there, we're actually gonna have to take a walk in another world. So we're gonna have to transform, guys. So give me 1 second. Let me transform really quick. Yeah, so here we are, Viewpoint Asia. So why don't you come along with me and take a journey with me on this next dimension while we go to our next special guest. Viewpoint Asia, here is the place that I have for you today. It's Pattaya Beach. Yeah, I know everybody, you're like, oh man, Q, what is this, man? Guys, don't worry, we're gonna have to take a little bit of a walk. So why don't we go and just see who our special guest is for you guys today. All right, Viewpoint Asia, here is the guest that I have for you today. He is a returning guest, Akhtar from Pakistan. So, Akhtar, how are you doing today?
I'm doing good, man.
Yeah. How has things changed, have they?
Yeah, many things happened. As you know, back home in Pakistan and India, many things changed now. Mm. They revoked the Article 370 and a lot of trouble, you know, in Kashmir.
Do you expect the economy of Pattaya to rebound during the high season this year?
Well, we are expecting, but not sure, you know. Recession all over, you know, it's in Europe as well. Mm. So we are expecting, but not sure about that.
The largest economies, as you said, in the world are all forecasting a recession.
Yeah.
That should be coming either by the end of this year or between 2020 or 2021. How will this affect businesses in Pattaya?
It's affect all over. If the economy is not good in Europe, so it already affect in Thailand as well. And Thai baht is also very strong now. When people come to Thailand, they don't spend more, you know, because of the Thai baht is so strong. So exchange rate, you know, is also matter.
So if the tourists stop coming, then how will that really affect the businesses around here?
I think most of them close then, because we just depend on tourists.
Yeah. Since I've been in Pattaya, I've noticed a remarkable number of business closures, including the Eurostar Hotel and restaurant. This has happened before the start of the high season. Do you think Thailand has already entered into a recession?
Yeah, I think they entered in a recession from 2008, I think, onwards. Everybody is struggling at the moment.
Wait a minute. We're now being told that we're getting ready to just enter into another recession after we just left the Great Recession of 2008.
Yeah.
The Great Recession is what we call it in the United States.
Yeah.
So do you mean to tell me that Thailand, which never left the Great Recession, is getting ready to slide into another recession?
Yes, I think so.
So is this really considered a recession, or is Thailand getting ready to slide into a depression?
I think it's a recession, I think.
A recession?
Yeah.
Is it a deeper recession, or how are we going to clarify if Thailand never really left the recession in 2008, and then businesses are struggling already before the high season, and the Eurostar Hotel and Restaurant has closed down before the start, and as well as other businesses here in Pattaya, and we have warnings coming out, we see Germany has slid into a technical recession.
Yeah.
You have the United States coming out and saying that we're getting ready to slide into a recession. South Africa has slid into a recession.
Yeah.
Is this a recession that we're getting ready to go into, or is this something more than a recession?
you can call it more than recession, because many things happen all over. The situation in Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, many things change now. If they start war over there, so it will affect all over, you know. So recession, and you can call it whatever you say.
So now you're talking about a recession in a war.
Yeah, that's right.
This recession, if the tourist numbers do not materialize for Thailand during this high season,
yeah,
what do you think the fate of Thailand's economy will be?
Thailand's economy, I think it will affect people like us, you know, like a business person. Already you can see many people, they close their business because the tourist is not coming to Thailand as we used to have before. The normal people like us, they're not going to survive if this season we don't have people like before. So many people, they don't survive. They have to close their business. And
if a lot of small businesses like you begin to close your doors, then what is that going to do to the Thai people who rely on you guys and depend on you guys for employment?
Thai people, they are local, you know, they can do anything. People like us, we have restrictions. We can't do this, you can't do that. So local people, they can do anything. They can work in a hotel, they can work in factories, and they can survive. But the foreigners, we just have limited scope, so it's a big problem for us.
If a place like the Eurostar Hotel and restaurant closes down,
yeah,
and then other hotels and restaurants close down because they're not able to bring in the numbers for the tourists because the tourists are not coming,
yeah,
and you have 5 or 6 or 7 or 10 restaurants closing down and hotels, yeah, closing down, yeah, then what does that mean for Thai people then?
Thai people, they just go back home. It's easy for them. In villages, they can work in rice fields or stuff like that, so they can survive.
Do you think the businesses will be able to renegotiate part of their loans with the banks to be able to stay operational?
No, I don't think so. The banks, they're not gonna renegotiate for the loan, you know.
Have a lot of people tried to renegotiate their loans with the bank?
The banks, they're not allowed to do that in Thailand. There is no chance for the negotiations.
A lot of other foreigners who come to Thailand, we have people from other countries that are not as strong as Thailand, so
yeah,
people from Myanmar who work here, people, yeah, from Cambodia, people from Laos.
Yeah.
What are going to happen to all these people who work here, who depend on the tourists, if Thailand goes into recession?
They're going to lose their jobs as well.
Are they going to stay here? Are they going to go back to their home countries? What's going to happen to all these people?
I think they'll go back because they don't have choice then. If they don't have work here, how can they survive? So they will go back.
So recently, India made international news by revoking Article 370, which granted Jammu and Kashmir autonomy. How does Pakistan feel about this decision?
This decision, I think it's nobody's gonna accept that. Even the Kashmiri people, even most of the Indian people also, they revoked the Article 370 and they have a big trouble now. So nobody's like, you know, Pakistan, as you know, they always with Kashmiri people. So they also don't like, and they go to United Nations and they try their best.
Can you tell us from your point of view what's happening in Kashmir?
They're killing innocent people in Kashmir. They're raping women, and schools are closed, there's curfew, there's no food, no medicine, nothing. So that's what happened now.
Why do you think India made this decision without the consent of the United Nations?
Because they claim Kashmir is a part of India, that's why. And the Kashmiri people, they don't accept it, and the Pakistan as well. That's why they think it's a part of India, so they just do it.
Why do you think the United States or China or Russia or the United Kingdom, especially the United Kingdom, since they are the ones who are the arbiter of these troubles between Kashmir, Jammu, Pakistan, and India, yeah, why haven't they said anything?
This problem become because of Britain, you know. when they left India, this part of Kashmir, they just leave it as it is. It's because of the Britons. If they solve this problem at that time, so no, nothing happened.
So do you think that the British should take a lot more responsibility since they created this issue?
I think they have to.
Why haven't they decided to step up in the United Nations?
United Nations, I think they don't do anything. They're just sitting and they don't care about innocent people. I don't think they are interested to solve this problem.
What good is the United Nations if the United Nations is not going to help disputes between countries?
They just help each other. They don't help the poor countries.
Do you think that the Shanghai Cooperation Organization could potentially be better than the United Nations today?
I think so.
How will this decision that India has made affect relationships between Pakistan, China, and Iran?
I think China is not allied with India. China, as you said, Iran, they also condemn this Article 370 they revoked. China, Iran, I think they both are with the Pakistan. China is also have some issues with the Kashmir, the part of Kashmir they call, I think, Ladakh. Yeah. So China is also with the Pakistan. India didn't tell anyone, and they just revoked the article, and they just claim this is a part of India.
Do you think there is a hidden power behind India's decision to revoke Article 370?
Yeah, I think so.
Who do you think is behind that decision?
I think my own thinking, you know, like Israel and yourself.
Myself? I cannot make those decisions, man. Why do you think the international community has remained silent about these developments?
Because everybody have their own agenda, you know. They don't want to interfere because they have the European countries, United States, Arab countries, they have a lot of business with India, you know. So they just keep quiet because of their businesses. So everybody is looking for their business. They don't look for the people of Kashmir. That's why.
Do you think this situation can be resolved?
I don't think so, man. Both countries are claiming the part of the Kashmir. I don't think they can resolve without war, you know. I think the war will happen.
You think a big war is going to happen?
Yeah, I think so.
Recently, Mark Carney made headlines when he called for the U.S. dollar to be replaced with an internationally backed digital currency. What are your thoughts on this?
Is it possible? I don't think it's possible at the moment, you know.
You don't think it's possible?
No, I don't think so. Nobody's going to join that.
No one's going to join it?
Yeah, I think so.
Do you think Pakistan and India is going to go to war?
The situation at the moment is, I think, they will go in a war.
Just on the Pakistani side, this war has to be funded. The only way to fund a war is to borrow money from the banks. Mm-hmm. The Pakistani government will have to print up trillions of rupees just to be able to fund the war and to be able to buy food and supplies for their military. Then you talk about the recruitment of people, then you talk about the acquisition of weapons, and then you talk about the invasion, the supply lines, the people who are involved, and on top of funding the government itself, India subsequently will have to do the same thing. So trillions of dollars will have to be made, making the Pakistani rupee completely worthless. After the war is over, there's going to be need to be rebuilding that's going to be done. But at that time, the Indian rupee, the Pakistani rupee, the US dollar, the Iranian dinar, the Chinese renminbi, the Japanese yen, the South Korean won, they're all going to be worthless pieces of paper. So where is the world, where's Pakistan going to get the money to be able to rebuild the infrastructure?
Because if it's happened like that, you know, so everybody is same, you know, not only Pakistan, it will affect all over. So let's see what happens.
If the central banks come out and they say, we have a new currency for everybody to use, And this is the currency that you guys are going to use after a war, or even during a war.
Yeah.
What would you do? Would you accept it?
Yeah, if there is no choice, then everybody accept, you know. So I don't think the situation is that bad, you know.
Yet.
Yeah. You can say that.
What are you willing to give up in order to have money transitioning over to a new system?
Well, I don't have that much money, so I don't have to think about that. I don't have to worry about that.
All right, everyone, this has been Q with another episode of Viewpoint Asia. Here with you with Akhtar from Pakistan. So guys, make sure if you ever come to Pattaya Beach, make sure you come by, you stop by Akhtar's shop, make sure you get yourself a nice suit. Akhtar is also, he's also going to launch a new product line. It's going to be traditional Pakistani clothes. So you guys make sure if you're looking for some nice traditional trends, if you're looking for a nice suit, Akhtar is your man here. So you guys be blessed. You guys have a beautiful and blessed day, and may the Most High smile upon all of you.